The Imperial Fists are recognised to be among the most loyal of the Emperor's legions. Terran-born, they will do whatever it takes to defend the Emperor and Holy Terror. Hello and welcome to this Horus Heresy painting video. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint a legionnaire in the colours of the Imperial Fists. However, by following the methods and techniques in this guide, you can easily apply it to any other model in your collection. So when you're ready, grab those brushes, shake those paints, let's get started. Now, before we begin painting, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. As you can see here, I've used Xandru dust. Now, this is perfect when applying yellow for our power armor, but if you don't have any Xandru dust, other undercoats will do the same job anyway. Now, the first colors we're going to be using are going to be base coats, and our first base coat is going to be Avalanche Sunset for that yellow armor. After that, we'll be using Corvus Black for any black details, and then for the eye lenses, we're going to be picking those out with Corax White. But first of all, let's start with that Avalanche Sunset. So, all I'm going to do is just get a couple of dollops onto my palette, a little bit of water, just so it's not too thick and goopy. A little bit more to that, that's better. And then all I'm going to do is just spin my brush around a couple of times to get a decent point, and then we're ready to start applying that to the power armor. Now, you might need to do a couple of thin coats of this, but if you have used a different undercoat, you might just need to add one or two more. Now that we've applied Avalanche Sunset to the armor, what we're now going to do is get Corvus Black and start picking out those black details. So I'm just going to start on those ribbly armor joins. Then I'll move on to the gun casing after. Again, if you're making a mistake, just get some Avalanche Sunset and tidy back up that armor. Now that we're done with the black details, we're just going to pick out those white eye lenses. So again, get your brush to a nice point. I'm using Corax White here. Just take your time. And if you make it too big or it comes off the edges, just get some Avalanche Sunset and tidy back up. Now that we've picked out those eye lenses and tied up around them, what we're now going to do is move on to picking out those silver details. And for this, we're going to be using Iron Hand Steel. So what I'm going to do is just grab a couple of little bits onto the palette, like so. Mix in a little bit of water so it's not too thick and goopy. And when you've done this, you might want to change your water as well so you don't end up contaminating your contrast paints. So once we're all pointed up there with a brush, all I'm going to now do is start picking out those silver areas. So you've got bits on the gun, got the, obviously these nodules here, or molecular studs as they're known. Just work your way around, take your time. Now that we've picked out all those silver details with Iron Hand Steel, what we're now going to do is move on to applying some contrast. Now the first contrast we're going to be using is Basilicanum Grey. I'm going to apply this over the black details and the silver details. So what I'm going to do is just load up my brush with some Basilicanum Grey. Now I'm just using the palette, just so I don't overload the brush and get a nice point to my bristles as well. Once I've done that, I'm then ready to start applying that. So I'm going to be coating it over, like I said, the silver areas and also those Corvus Black areas. Now, it's ideal doing this at this point because if we do make any mistakes, we can easily tidy up that yellow. With that Basilicanum Grey now applied to the silver and black details, we're just going to move on to applying the rest of our contrast. Starting first, on the armour, we're going to be using Ironed in Yellow. We're going to thin this down with Contrast Medium. Then after that, we're going to pick out those eye lenses using a bit of Blood Angels Red. But first of all, let's start with our mix. So what I'm going to do here is get myself three paintbrushes worth of Contrast Medium. And then give my brush a quick wash and a dry. And then one paintbrush of Ironed in Yellow. Just mix those together. A little bit thinner, but that's great. So what I'm going to do now is just load up my brush and just remove some and get a little bit of a point to my brush. And then all we're then going to do is then coat that over the armour. So I'm just going to start from the bottom on the feet here, like so, work my way around. And what that's going to do is just going to change the tone of that yellow, make it a little bit more punchy, and then it's going to settle in those recesses, giving you some nice definition. And then take your time, and if you do find it pooling, just use your brush to soak up any excess. There we are with the Ironed in Yellow and Contrast Medium mix now dry. All I'm now going to do is just get a little bit straight from the pot to add a little bit more depth into those recesses. Now that we're done with the Ironed in Yellow, what we're now going to do is get a little bit of Blood Angels Red and just drop that into the eye lenses. Again, with having that white base coat, as it dries, it will look like they're glowing red. Thank you. Now that we've applied all those contrasts, what we're now going to do is move on to some highlighting. So first of all, we're going to highlight the armor with a dry brush of Screaming Skull. Then we're going to get some Rhinox hide and do some chipping, first with a sponge and then after that with a brush for some finer detail. Then finish off highlighting our silvers using Stormhost Silver. But first of all, let's start with our dry brush. So I'm just going to get myself a small dry brush, a little bit of Screaming Skull. And all I'm going to do is do some circular motions, crisscross motions. What we're aiming to do here is just remove as much of that pigment as possible, but still leaving traces of it on the bristles. So all I'm going to do is just move to the side there. It's perfect. And I'm just going to gently start rubbing this across the actual model. So all I'm going to do is go sideways, up and down. And as you can see, as I'm doing it, just picking out those extreme edges. Just giving it a nice little dry brush. And take your time, work your way around. If you do find you get some on the black and the silver, you can just quickly tidy back up over those if you need to. There we are, that highlight now done. What we're now going to do is move on to chipping up the armour. Now I'm going to start first by using a sponge. This could be any kind of sponge, figure case sponge or household sponge. And once that's done, we're then just going to use a brush to pick out some larger chips and flicks. So first of all, I'm just going to get a little bit of figure case sponge. I'm going to dip that into Rhinox hide, like so. And I'm just going to start applying that to the palette. I'm just going to dab it, a bit like how we do with dry brush, and we're trying to remove a lot of the pigment here. Once I've dabbed it enough, still want to leave some on there, so I'm happy with that. Then all I'm going to do is move on to the actual model itself and then just start gently weaving that around, making the armour look a bit damaged and war-torn. Take your time. Sometimes you can overdo it, so just be mindful on how much you apply. Now that we've done that sponge chipping, all I'm going to do is get some Rhinox hide on a brush and just add a few more little chips and flicks here, mainly in areas that I struggle to actually get the sponge into, so like areas under there, so you can just work your way around, just doing some little dots and flicks. There we are, that armor now chipped up. What we're now going to do is move on to highlighting the metal, and for this we're going to be using Stormhost Silver. I'm just going to get that, use the edge of the brush where I can. Just take my time. You don't have to go mad, just picking out little areas here and there, mainly where the light will catch. With that highlight now finished, our model is now ready to be based. So we're going to start first by applying some Astro Granite. Once that's all applied and dry, we're then going to get some Basilicon and Grey, coat that over, and finish off with a dry brush of Screaming Skull. But first of all, I need to get my trusty texture tool and use the large scoop side first, just get some of that out of the pot, and then I'm just going to apply that to the base. So all I'm going to do is just move that around here like so, and then I'm going to move to the smaller side for a little bit more accuracy. Okay, just take your time, just work your way around. With the Astro Granite now fully applied, what we're now going to do is start coating over it with Basilicon and Grey. And this is straight from the pot. Just take your time, make sure you don't splodge it on places you don't want it. With that Basilicon and Grey now applied, what we're now going to do is just dry brush over using Screaming Skull. And just a soft dry brush just to pick out those edges, add a bit of warmth to that grey. Those details on the base now done, all that's left to do is paint the rim of the base in a colour that matches your army. For ours, we've used Steel Legion Drab. With our model and base finished, our Imperial Fist Legionnaire is ready to hold the line against any traitors of the Imperium. Now, there's a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when using base paints, try and be as neat as you can. Remember, the neater you are, the better the end result. And if you do make any mistakes, you can always tidy back up at a later point. Also, when using shades or contrasts, try not to overload your brush as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find that happening, just dry off your brush and soak up any excess. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy painting your own Imperial Fists, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.